This is Luke. 6 years ago, this van was used for a pressure washing business.
You got that wiggle.
But today, it's getting its third rewire.
I'm definitely jealous of the system that Luke's got. It's state of the art, top of the range. It doesn't get any better at this point in time.
We've been completely ripping all the electrics out of this van. We've replaced those heavy old AGM batteries.
Luke documented the conversion of this van on his YouTube channel, Luke's VanLife.
I travelled around Europe for 3 or 4 weeks, but didn't really like what I'd built. So I came home, ripped it all out again, did a whole new conversion, which is what this conversion is here today.
Luke's travelled all over the United Kingdom, as well as a number of Western European countries.
You do adjust to the size. It is different to a house. Storage is a huge issue. So you need plenty of cupboards if you can. But the pros outweigh the cons. You know, you get to park beside amazing views, be outside in the mountains or, you know, in the lake. So it's a fantastic way to travel and a good way to live.
Part of the van life living is regularly meeting up with others who either live full-time or part-time in a range of vans and camper vans, just like Luke.
We pretty much stand in front of our vans the whole weekend talking to people. So I'm stood by the side of the van here, people sticking their head in the van and having a look.
Some people are full-timers in motorhomes. People these days want to go off-grid and they want to do it for, you know, days if not weeks. And to do that, you need a lot of battery storage. And you also need a method of recharging that whilst you're away from a campsite.
He's now off to meet his friend and new business partner, Mark, in a farm building in the rolling hills of beautiful Herefordshire in England. The aim by the end of the week is to replace most of the electrics with a range of Victron energy equipment, and they have the skills to do it themselves.
People come to us, ask a lot of questions. That's fine, that's what we're there for, you know. So they come to us, they ask the questions, we design a solution for them, we spec the solution out, and Luke will go and install it.
I have a 12-volt compressor fridge, the Dometic CRX50 here. I have a diesel heater, which keeps the van warm. Lights, sockets, cameras, LED lights that you'll see on the outside of the van. And it's quite minimal. It's just all the chargers that you need for charging your phones and devices.
The first things to go are an old DC to DC charger and two heavy 12-volt, 115-amp-hour lead carbon AGMs.
Oh my goodness.
He's replacing them with one Victron Energy 200 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery.
If you buy AGM batteries, you're likely to replace them every 3 to 5 years, even if you look after them really, really well. So 200 charge cycles a maximum. Lithium batteries, lithium iron phosphate batteries, you're looking at up to 5,000 charge cycles. So really and truly, if you look after them, they're going to outlive you pretty much in their van, certainly outlive the van. It's an investment that you'll make and it'll last you 10 to 15, maybe even 20 years.
The bulk of the equipment is going in a custom-made box that'll be shown right by the main door. It's quite a simple DC-only system.
He's got 300 watts of solar on the roof, which goes through his 130 MPPT controller. He's also got an Orion, so when he's driving, he can top up his batteries that way. The Orion is a great bit of kit. It's a DC to DC charger. It works with older vehicles with standard alternators. It works with newer vehicles with a smart alternator. With the Orion, it takes that current, it boosts it to the right current for your battery, the right voltage and current to charge your lithium batteries all the time. So that never drops off. So when that engine is running and outputting voltage, the Orion will take that voltage, get it to the correct voltage and amps, and get it through to your battery. It all goes through the Lynx shunt BMS through to the Lynx distributor, and it's all controlled and held together by the Servo GX.
They've used the new temperature control option in the servo, together with a Ruvi smart sensor, to regulate the cabinet's temperature. If the temperature inside the cabinet gets too warm, the servo will activate one of its relays to turn on four small fans. Two at the bottom to pull cool air in, and two at the top to push warm air out. The cabinet isn't just powering Luke's van with the DC power, it also doubles up as a Victron Energy show cabinet. Luke's using the other relay in the servo to activate blue lights for everyone to see.
So the reason these electrics are on display like that is so that whenever I'm at these shows and meets, people can see, they can see all the Victron products in there. They can see the lithium battery through this display window on this side. It's on show for everyone to have a look at, see what we can do. Some of the times people have done the electrics themselves, but they're not happy with it, or they're a bit worried that it's not safe or it's untidy, and they want me to come and just tidy it all up. Which I really enjoy, getting all the cables nice and neat. I take it all apart and start again. But yeah, a lot of the time it's the full electrical install. Sometimes it's older motorhomes and they're not happy with the system, so that needs ripping out and setting up a new off-grid 12-volt system.
I had a T6 camper and I wanted a leisure battery in it, but I also wanted to be able to go off-grid a bit. So I started looking inside. I knew nothing about it. I bought some cheap stuff off eBay, as you do. And I got so fed up with it, I'm like, what's the best out there? So I started doing some Googling, came across Victron. Okay, so I bought this, I think it was a 115 smart, I think it was only just out, I think. Plugged that in, thought, yeah, this works, I really like this. You know, people are like, oh, you've got Victron.
Victron just works. You put it in, it does exactly what it's supposed to do. All of the Victron devices talk to each other and to do the same goal at the end of the day. So the cheaper Chinese brands that you get, they don't charge quite the same or as well. And if you have different chargers doing different things, it doesn't prolong the life of your leisure batteries. So if you go for all Victron, they can all work together to do the same goal.
I think it's going to be over the moon. Because now he's got his solar and he's got his Orion, he can charge whenever he likes. He doesn't have to worry about keep watching the batteries and running the engine all day or going for a drive just to top things up, because he's been off grid for quite a few days.
Luke's connected the servo to VRM so he can check and control his van anywhere online. He already has a full calendar of shows to attend this year. He also now has a rewired van full of Victron equipment and an electrics cupboard he and Mark can be proud of.